Hi guys, it's May. Welcome brothers and sisters to my latest unboxing video. And this is a big one. It's a car. It's a real car in a real box. It is in fact the Toyota Yaris Gerimana, the Gazoo Racing Masters of the Nürburgring. Complete bollocks, I know. There's some stats on the car which I'm going to show you in a minute. But first, to show that this isn't some sort of stunt, let's have a look at the box. So you might be imagining, it's just a cardboard facade with a car behind it, but it isn't. There's the front. There is the illustration. There's the pull-off tab. We'll have a go at that in a minute. There's the end of the box. It's a real box. Now going around the other side of the box, it's still a box, look. And indeed, if we go down to the other end, it's a box. And look on the top. That is a box, no trickery. It's a real box with a real car in it. I'm just putting this back on the tripod and then we'll continue. Get on your bitch. So some stats on this car, which are printed on the side of the box as there would be if this were a toy. In fact, I'm going to bring you in a bit closer so you can get a proper look at this because it's important. So here are the stats. The engine, 1.8 litre four-cylinder, very on message, slightly downsized from the hot hatch norm. You'd expect 2 litres. It's supercharged, slightly unusual because, well, a supercharger is driven mechanically off the engine, whereas a turbocharger, far more common, is driven by exhaust gases. There are advantages, disadvantages to both. The supercharger doesn't suffer any lag. It responds immediately. It does give you more mechanical drag. The turbocharger doesn't give any mechanical drag. It seems like it's almost free extra power because it's being driven by exhaust gases, which obviously, their exhaust, are waste. But there is lag, no matter how sophisticated it is, and they run at very high temperatures. So that's an interesting idea. 6-speed manual, yeah, that's what you'd expect. 209 horsepower, pretty good. 184 pound-feet, pretty good as well. 143 miles per hour. 6.3 seconds, 0 to 62, that's good. 37.7 miles per gallon, very good. Just over 1.1 tons, nice. Now, the next thing to do is take it out of the box, and I'm gonna dwell on this very slightly. Stand by. So the box is made of cardboard, as boxes generally are. I think there are probably polystyrene inserts inside there to keep the car safe during transit. And we begin by pulling off the tear tab here. And that's quite satisfying already, just one of those. And I've got all those to go. Very nice. I reckon, oh, yes. I reckon orgasm will be achieved by about there or there. Let's see. Oh. Oh. Nurse. I believe it's white. But let's see. You ready? Oh, yes. Sorry. What do you think? That noise is not farting, it's the box that makes that. There you go, fart box. Hang on. Excuse me. I'll just make sure that the end is in shot before I take, in fact, I'm going to take you round the end for the end shot. This is where we will get to see its face for the first time. Ready? Oh, It's not there yet. There are the polystyrene inserts. Nice piece of polystyrene. Piece of polystyrene is always useful if you've got a hot wire cutter to turn it into an interesting sculpture, objet, conversation piece. Don't dump it in the sea. It's very buoyant and it gets in the mouths of whales and dolphins. Okay? Use it responsibly. Turn it into something attractive. Here we go. Hang on, the front of the box is in the way of the polystyrene insert. Second. Half a face. That smells of fresh polystyrene. That's all part of the excitement of having something new. Remember, you only unbox something once. Something that has once been unboxed can never be boxed again because it's already been unboxed. This is a one-time event. It's a bit like the Big Bang or your own personal Big Bang. Can't do that for a second time. The whole face. Look at this. This is the Gazoo Racing Deckles. Red bit, it's got lipstick on in effect. It's got a bit of a pout. That's nice, nice big Toyota badge. That's fabulous. It's even still got some protective wrapping on the windscreen. Oh, this is always very pleasant pulling this off for the first time. It will never be as clean again as it is in this moment when this first comes off. And it makes a nice noise. You ready? If I can get a consistent note out of it, hang on. Here we go. Look how clean that is. I'll do this closer to my microphone to really annoy you. Good, eh? Right, now I'm going to take the back off. We're going to have a look at that. That also gets more light on the car. Then we'll go inside and unpack the interior. I'll move you, viewer, round to the other end. Excuse me, I had the dial for lunch. Back of box. Oh, I like that a lot. Gazoo Racing, Masters of the Nürburgring. Yaris, a name that you associate with a rather worthy car, sort of, I would buy one for my mother type car, but not here. That, yes, Yaris, that, very, very potent hot hatch. A master of the Nürburgring, no less. Single central pipe, nice lights, bit of aerodynamic detail. Nice, small wing. 80s. Excellent. Right. Let's have a look inside. Somewhere in or on this box is the key. Let's have a look for that. Excuse me. It's not on the roof, it's not under the windscreen wiper. It is locked. So I'm guessing. Excuse me. The key, I'm assuming that's what this is and not a pair of cufflinks. This is an unboxing event in itself. It's an unboxing within the unboxing. Ho, ho, ho. Ho, ho. Oh, the inside is boxed as well. Are you getting this? Can you see? Steering wheel is boxed, the seats are boxed, even the gear stick is boxed. I'll bring you in to look at that in a minute. It's lovely sports steering wheel, a little red bit at the top to tell you when you're going in a straight line. Controls, the seat. I'm going to bring you around to see the seat. Excuse me. Sorry if the camera wobbles a bit, that's because it's on the piece of cardboard that was the side of the box, but I can't be bothered to move it. Okay, get that off there. Fantastic height adjust, rear rake adjust, all the things you'd expect. Here's a bit of box. Can you see this? On the gear shift. If I were alone, obviously I'd try that on my head. I'm going to bring you in for that first illumination of the dashboard. Oh yeah, all right, I've got to press the clutch as well. God, I was born in the 60s, I know this stuff. Red needles, warning lights, Gazoo Racing. Look at that. I'm going to drive it forwards and then I'll meet you down there to look at the owner's handbook. Stand by. Oh, feel the power, feel the supercharger. I've run over my own box. So now, I hope you are sitting, lying on your bed or whatever comfortably, because we're going to have a quick look at the owner's handbook. Something I always find slightly depressing, to be honest. Firstly, because I don't know if this is true with cars, but when you buy something like a new tablet or a mobile phone or a digital camera, if you look at that quick start guide that comes with it, usually the first thing it does is tell you how to throw it away, which I find annoying when I've just spent hundreds of pounds on something. The other thing that's boring about these is all the warnings. I'll just put my specs on and we'll find a couple. Now, some I've encountered in the past, for example, on a motorcycle I once bought, there was a section that told you how to check the tire pressures, and then it advised you not to attempt this whilst the motorcycle is in motion because this could lead to an accident and death. Well, almost certainly, I'd say. They've got to put that in because otherwise lawyers will be on their backs. I've also got a handbook for a car somewhere that tells you not to drink the contents of the battery. Not that you were going to, obviously, but they have to put it in. And the annoying thing about it is that somewhere in here, there could be a genuine warning that says, don't press that button to the right of the stop-start button under any circumstances because it makes the car explode. But you won't see that because you'll get to page 2, 3, warning. Do not wear the shoulder belt under your arm. No shit, Sherlock. And once you've read a few of those, pregnant women, yeah, all right, obviously, you don't do certain things if you're pregnant. Stowing the seatbelt. Ensure that all passengers wear a seatbelt. Well, yes, that's what they're there for. Warning, observe the following precautions regarding the SRS airbags. Failure to do so may cause death. Incorrect use of the seatbelt may cause death. You've just spent, I can't remember what it is, £21,500 on this thing, and you pick up the book that comes with it, and it tells you all the ways it can kill you and how you should throw it away. So you've just spent over £26,000 on this very exciting hot hatchback car, and you open the book that comes with it, and it tells you all the ways it's going to kill you and how to throw it away. I don't think that's really good enough. Let me find you another one. If the engine has to be turned off while driving. Well, no, it doesn't. You would never do that. This section is called When Trouble Arises. They're sort of trying to put it nicely. Trouble won't arise. It's a Japanese car. Do not touch the wheels or the area around the brakes immediately after the vehicle has been driven. After the vehicle has been driven, the wheels and the area around the brakes may be extremely hot. Yes, they will. The way brakes work is converting kinetic energy into heat. That's exactly why the car slows down. The energy that the car had because it was moving now becomes extreme warmth. So yes, it will burn your hands. I've never driven my car vigorously, then got out and thought, I wonder if I should touch the wheels. I never do, and neither will you. The honest truth about this sort of thing is, this is a car. It's not a machine tool. It's not a machine gun. It's not a space shuttle. If you can't work out how to use it by simply using it, it hasn't been designed properly. So this, not that anybody ever reads them anyway. Thank you for watching.